Anything like, I'm Rich Mo Gaming. And welcome to... Until Dawn, yes. We are back. We are here for Until Dawn today. I already completed the game. So, I'm going to start again. The butterfly effect. A tiny butterfly flapping its wings today may lead to a devastating hurricane weeks from now. Oh god. Hiccups. Not hiccups today. The smallest decision can dramatically change the future. Your actions will shape how the story unfolds. Your story is one of many possibilities. Choose your actions carefully. Because I haven't done... I remember how the story goes. I'm not gonna spoil it because some of you guys haven't seen this. Hannah, you look so damn hot in that shirt, but I bet you're even hotter out of it. Come to the guest room at 2 a.m.
Oh my god. What did our naive sister get herself into now?
Hold on, guys. Let me just sort out the settings so you can see what it says. I'm still going to read it out, you know. But this is going to help you with it.
Maybe we should start with a little, you know, making out and see where it goes from there.
Oh my god, she's taking her shirt off. What? Oh my god.
sorry, Anna.
It's all right. Just a stupid prank. Hey, you guys are jerks. You know that? Anna!
Okay. I'm liking this game so far. Trying to... Oh god. Clicked it again. Oh, what's that? It's a totem. A death totem. Okay. Okay, that's cool. He's... goddamn hiccups.
Thank you.
analysis. The scarecrow. Scared. Okay, that was a great intro, actually. I know I've already played it, but... this will be good.
Thank you.
left the safety of their parents' lodge and headed out into a snowstorm.
Foul play.
Not officially, no. There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently unknown. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. He has warned them against pursuing their construction project and claimed the land was sacred to his forefathers.
You know, there is still the old sanatorium on the mountain.
My officers did search the grounds, but the girls themselves couldn't have made it that far.
Something about that mountain seems to breed tragic events.
More than you know, Marty.
Well, thank you for joining us, Anthony. Call the Washingtons tonight. Their son, Josh, on this, the anniversary of the mysterious disappearance of Hannah and Beth Washington.
Well, hello, friends and fans. All right, let's do that again. All right. Well, hello, friends and fans. It's beyond awesome to have you guys all back this year. First off, I gotta say, I am super excited to welcome all my pals back to the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway.
Okay, so I like this game. Oh, that's finer though. Memento Mori. 10 hours until dawn. Oh my god, he's there. Sam, Hannah's best friend. Intelligent, considerate, and adventurous. After the cable car station.
What?
The gate's busting. Climb over, Chris. Chris wasn't lying. These hiccups, though. Okay. Let's do it quick. And let's jump. Yes. Let's go. See, I succeeded that. I'm like, I've got a really steady hand. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna read all that. In Diogenes people and butterfly prophecies, tribes who have once lived in these mountains believe that butterflies carry dreams and prophecies of possible futures. The color of the butterfly indicated the nature of the prophecy. Death. Black butterflies prophesized the dreamer's death. Danger. Red butterflies warned of dangerous events. Lost brown butterflies foretold of tragedy affecting friends. Guidance. Yellow butterflies offered visions to help and guide. Fortune. White butterflies brought dreams of luck and good fortune. And there's another totem there. Guidance totem. So it was a yellow totem, I guess. That's what you want to call it. Chris has a crush on Ashley. Methodical, protective, and humorous.
Oh, so I found something kind of amazing.
What?
I'm not going to tell you. You got to see for yourself. This way.
Where?
Right around here. Gonna blow your mind.
I kind of hope so now.
Ta-da! Pretty rad, right?
Yeah!
Come on, look at these beauties!
Beauties is not the word that comes to mind. Why is this even here?
What do you mean?
What the hell is a shooting range doing at the base of the ski lodge?
Dude, have you ever met Josh's dad?
Yeah.
This is like Grizzly Adams or something. Don't try.
Okay, so now I'm gonna be Chris, I guess, so I can shoot stuff. Pilgrim Victor, sex male, height 6.2 or 108 aka meters. Last known address, Blackwood Pines, last seen 1998 on the 3rd and 16th month. No, the 16th and 3rd month. Wanted in connection with a first degree of arson offence and well as various death threats. Anyone with information regarding this dangerous criminal should contact the BPMC as soon as possible. Blackwood Provincial Mountain Constability Police Monty Principal D. Blackwood, 1998. Okay. Okay. So these videos are going to be quite long.
What a crazy place to set up house.
No matter how Blackwood Pines Hotel and Sanatorium for a healthy body and mind. These are going to be quite long.
Here, aren't we?
Bro, good talk.
You know what? Let's just stop talking about what happened. Enjoy the trip.
Yeah, you're right.
You know how Josh and I met?
No.
Third grade. Josh sat in the back of the room. I sat in the front. We didn't even know each other existed. But the kid sitting next to Josh started strap snapping the training bra on the girl in front of him. So the teacher made him move to the front. I was
sick. Okay, so
I got moved to the back.
And
next to Josh. That's how we met. We became friends to this day.
That's
if it weren't for the fact that Jesus had been sick to read like 3 years earlier, on that day decided to look both of the earth and show up the tree from. I mean, who knows? You could be riding in this cable car alone. Right now. Or talking to some other person entirely. Boom. Butterfly effect.
Jess, Mike's new girlfriend. Confident, trusting, irreverent.
Time to meet and greet.
die. That's my motto.
Oh, you're such an idiot. Maybe nosy Nancy shouldn't go nosing around in other people's nostrils.
Yeah, I try not to do that, as a rule.
Come on, Jess, you can tell us. You can totally keep secrets. Whatever. You'll figure it out eventually.
Alright, let's just go this long road. It's getting tired of all this.
You guys go ahead. I'm just gonna wait here for a bit. Be who else is coming. What? I mean, you know, whoever.
Sam?
Did you see this view? I mean, holy cow. Sometimes I forget to just stop and take it all in. Seriously, couldn't they have built the lodge, like, right where the cable car ends?
Emily, Mike's ex. Intelligent, resourceful, persuasive.
How long have you been like this? Pretty.
Matt, Emily's new boyfriend. Motivated, ambitious, active.
And where's the bellboy when you need one?
Emily's ex. Intelligent, driven, persuasive.
You got it.
Michael!
You really, really should have taken your face so right. Dude, I almost clocked just now. Nice one.
Michael, you're a jerk.
Come on. Guys, we're all friends here, right? No need for violence, just a little harmless fun. Love the woods, spooky. Come on, let's get in the spirit of things.
The spirit of things? Seriously, what's wrong with you?
Just trying to lighten the mood, Em. Michael, I'm just going to lay it out, otherwise this whole weekend is going to suck ass for everyone. This is super awkward, and we all know it. Let's just acknowledge it now and move on, okay?
Yeah.
I hate you, man. I get it. I don't want to make this weird.
By the way, all the old videos on the Xbox 360, they will not be recorded anymore, because I'm not on it anymore. Let's continue.
What?
Hey, could you take these the rest of the way?
The bags?
Yeah. All the bags.
Why?
I need to go find Sam.
Okay.
Sorry, I really need to go find her. I totally forgot I needed to talk to her before we get all the way up there.
I just really can't wait. We're almost there.
It's important. Matt, please.
So important, I guess I can pack horse it the rest of the way. But you owe me one.
Excuse me?
Well, then we're even, at least.
I'll think about it.
Just be careful.
You have been cheating. Thank you.
Okay. That's done. Ashley has a crush on Chris. Academic, inquisitive, forthright. Okay, guys.
Oh!
Hey, whoa. Sorry there. Sorry about that ass. I didn't mean to scare
just
you.
Just wait.
Well, I didn't mean to scare you. Sort of scare you. But not like for real.
Oh, gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Hey, well. Man, I'm sorry, Ash.
It's okay. It's fine.
Hold it. address nothing with him? Ever?
I don't know. Damn. Matt.
Stay out here pretty much ever, provided I was making out with you the whole time.
Just making out?
Quote, unquote.
Well, I think we might bring to death somewhere between those quotes.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so we're going to do this.
Hello again. And how are we? In our last session, we established that you have a fear of things that are dead or undead. This time, we're going to try to understand the root of your anxiety.
Okay. I'm just gonna flick through this because... yeah, I wouldn't say it, but guys, I've got to speak through this. most of you might fear clowns. This is previously answered one. I'm gonna leave it here, guys, because previously is for the next episode, so you can remember what happened in case you forgot. Because I don't know when I'll next do this. I've been Ritio Gaming. Bye, guys.